1, go!
Autonomous underway for this qualification match. The first launch from Winovation in red bumpers. Over on blue, though, laser beams fired from cross-threaded. Their alliance partner Eagle Army up on that bottom port, entering a few power cells of their own as time expires in Autonomous. A Red Alliance lead with drivers at the reins now. 6 power cells scored during Autonomous for the Red Alliance, and 5 scored for the Blue Alliance. Red Alliance power cells were worth a few more points, though. They had more of those going into the inner and outer port, whereas the Blue Alliance had a few entered into the bottom port, only worth 2 points apiece. Completing the first cycle looks like Wild saying 111 for the Red Alliance and Eagle Army for the Blue Alliance. Eagle Army using their flywheel to go up and in, banking off the roof of the power port for the Blue Alliance. Winovation now in red bumpers, making their way back toward the Red Alliance driver station, and cross-threaded, showing what they can do with their long-range launcher, going for a long shot from behind the Blue Alliance control panel. CyberDogs in red bumpers, possibly searching for a game piece on the playing field floor. They will collide with Blue Alliance robots, and for Blue, once again, cross-threaded. They go 2 for 4 with the long shot behind the control panel. The advantage on that shot is that they are very close to their loading zone, just about 10 feet between them and a limitless supply of game pieces. More of those power cells being entered by Winovation and Wildstang for their human player to deploy back into the playing field. Both alliances have activated stage 1 of their shield generator with under 1 minute remaining in the match. The Red Alliance has come awfully close to reaching capacity for stage 2, and cross-threaded continues to try those long range shots, while Wildstang goes up 4 for 4, adding at least 8 more points to that Red Alliance lead. As the end game begins, Winovation and CyberDogs lined up underneath the Red Alliance shield generator switch. We know that Wildstang can do a remarkably quick and accurate climb, but coming for the Blue Alliance, cross-threaded and Eagle Army both in contact with the shield generator switch, and the first off the playing field floor. 50 points for the Blue Alliance, that could be enough, but Wildstang and Winnow, they match it. 50 points of their own as long as they remain supported only by that switch at the conclusion of qualification match number 62. Taking home 3 ranking points, 2 for the win, 1 for the level generator switch, and 2 robot hangs. But Blue does not walk away empty-handed. They also have 2 hanging robots and a level generator switch at the end of qualification match number 60.